My teacher, Mrs. Gillies, she's really fun.
She's nice because she lets us use all this technology.
And also, since she lets us use the iPods and computers, it's really fun. And she's nice and awesome.
I am Tracey Gillis. I'm a fourth grade teacher at Gulf Highlands Elementary School. I do what I call a faux flipped math classroom, where the students are watching lessons on the computer before they ever come see me. The true model of flipped classroom is the students would watch a lesson at home on their computer, and then they would come into class with questions. So they've learned all the instruction before they ever come into class. My students don't typically have computers or internet at home, so they watch the lessons here at school. They love it. Typically, I've seen that my higher students and my lower students are the one that benefit the most, because the higher students can watch the lesson and understand it right away and never even have to come see me to ask questions, and the lower students will watch the same video over and over again until they understand it.
It's different from my old school because we use computers for math, because at my old school, the teacher used to teach it on a whiteboard, and it gets a little boring, but when it's on the computer, it's more fun.
The first thing that they do is they watch the lesson, and they have a little checklist to keep them focused on what they're supposed to do. After they watch the lesson, they're supposed to do a ticket to group.
A ticket to group is a problem that you're gonna bring to group that proves that you watched the lesson.
This year on our first unit math test, I had 90% of my kids at proficient, and my class average was an 87%, which is significantly higher than last year, where I had on the first unit test about 80%, and then the year before, where only my lowest students were doing the flips, I had probably about 65% proficient. So I've seen a huge growth in data.
You can go at your own pace whenever you want, and we just keep on going and doing it instead of the teacher just telling us all together, because some people do things faster than others.
I get to spend a lot of time with the kids this way because I know where every kid is and I get to meet their needs. Some kids don't need to come to groups, some do.
It's fun to learn that way because then you're not have to learn stuff over and over again with other people because they don't know it.
The videos themselves only take me about 10 to 15 minutes to record. It's finding all the resources to put on the Moodle site so that if they don't understand the video, they have other videos they can go watch. There's centers, there's games, there's summarizers, there's quizzes. All that takes a good portion of my time. I would say for each unit of math, I'm probably spending about 8 hours. But I'll have to do that this year. Next year, I won't have that at all because it'll all be set to go.
She has to put a lot of work in because she has to make every video, and then she has to find questions to put into the quizzes, and then she has to keep up with everyone, and then she has to give everyone the right thing so they don't get the wrong stuff to do.
The parents love it because everything's posted online. So a lot of them don't understand the new math and the way we teach it, and they can actually go online and see the videos themselves. So I've had nothing but positive feedback when I don't have questions about homework anymore, I don't have questions about what I'm teaching. It's all right there for them to see, and their grades are online as well too, so they know right where their child is. I'm very fortunate that my administration is on board. They support me in every way. Kara buys me books. She sends me articles to really push me even further into it. My favorite part is that I'm not the expert in the room. I am just one more of the students that they can come and ask for help. You'll see that they ask each other for help with the technology and even the math. They learn it before they even come to me. They are becoming problem solvers on their own. If they don't understand something, they will Google it themselves now before they come to me. That's probably my favorite part.